Let me tell you a short story. I was worried for my lung cancer patients. So I came to my general manager of the hospital. It's a publicly owned healthcare system, right? So and he told me, okay, this is very costly. You cannot do NGS for all your lung cancer patients. So I decided to go to a team of economists and run a cost-benefit study. And we found that by doing NGS, we were able to find more additional alterations in our cohort of patients. That was about 2,000 new alterations. And we were able to enroll about 89 patients in a clinical trial, additional clinical trials, not open yet for people without these alterations. And then we were able to save about 3,000 quality adjusted years of life. So the impact for the value of this life of these patients was great. Impact on these patients, on the amount of life and on the quality of life is key for us. And that was made thanks to NGS. So at the end of the day, after my conversation with the general manager, I told him, this is not a matter of cost. This is a matter of value added to the system, because we add more life and more quality of life to our patients. And this is our goal, our shared goal. Don't you think so? And he approved the NGS for our patients. Our hospital is a referral center for all rare cancers in southern Spain. And you have two main advantages of NGS-based testing over single-gene testing. And one is diagnostic, because we get all kinds of rare cancers, and sorting them out is very important. And to get the right diagnosis is very important, to put the name and the surname of the tumor. But on the other hand, we can find lots of therapeutic targets in our cancers, allowing the oncologists to treat them in a different way. So we have a double advantage, a better diagnosis, a more precise diagnosis, and a more precise therapy. Don't you think this is a great advantage?